When they illegally arrested me and put me in prison, and they were trying to tease me, because I was not lying down or sleeping, I was just sitting in samadhi, in Padmasana literally, and constantly sitting in samadhi for days. They were trying to tease me. They were watching this through CCTV and they were trying to tease me. Oh, without a big bed, you are not able to sleep. They gave just a small paper with which that tiles get packed, because that time they were doing a tiling of that area where they kept me illegally, where they held me illegally, and tiling that area. So they gave that paper with which the tiles get packed and gets delivered, that paper. And they were teasing, oh, you need bed. I said, no, even this paper is too much for me. I don't need. A consciousness prepared for minimalism is the ultimate luxury a man can yearn. Understand? I'm giving you one example. Consciousness prepared for minimalism is the ultimate luxury a man can yearn. The ultimate luxury, Lakshmi, for a man is consciousness matured for aparigraha, minimalism. You know, some of the items in your house, you have not touched it or used it for last even 3-4 years. But your consciousness will not allow you to give that away or donate it or gift it away and clear it. That is what I say, clustered consciousness. Clustered consciousness keeps the home clustered. Just look around. If you are retaining any item which you have not touched or used for 6 months, you are cluttered consciousness. Sorry, it's not clustered, cluttered. Sorry for my Indian idli English. Sometimes I need to remember that I'm a village boy, not learnt English formally. Anyhow, listen, the cluttered mind keeps the cluttered home. Look around. If you have not used something for last 6 months and you don't have use of that for next 6 months and still you are keeping it, your mind is cluttered.